Hey everyone guys, I am Pavel here from techytube.com and this is video number 26, MVC design pattern in iOS development. In this tutorial we will not write any line of code, instead we will discuss in depth the MVC pattern, which stands for Model View Controller. I found a very useful online resource at this link right here. And don't worry, as I'll put this link in the description of the video. And on this page we have a nice diagram that will help you guys to better understand this design pattern. As you might already guess, the MVC consists of three parts: a model object, a view object, and a controller object. Think of a model of all your data that your application contains. For example, in a contacts application, the model will be any user that's in the database. The model could be also the list of all the users that are in that specific database. The view is how your application looks like, and think of it in terms of buttons, labels, table views, images, and all stuff like that. As you can see, our model will never communicate with its view, and its view will never communicate with its model. And that means our model should be user interface independent, and the same thing applies to the view. It should be very generic and reusable in other iOS apps. The controller can directly communicate both with its model and with its view. And the model can communicate with the controller, but only by using notifications. It cannot communicate directly with that. Also, the controller can directly communicate with its views, but the view can communicate with its controller in a way called target action. Don't worry too much if at this moment you don't understand very well what MVC is, as it's a kind of abstract model, and you'll understand better as we'll write some code and you see how everything works and what everything is in a real old app. When we are writing iOS apps, the class that represents the controller is usually a class that inherits from UI View Controller standard class, and that class may also have a XIB file associated with it. And that XIB file basically represents our view, and on the XIB file we can have as many visual elements as we want. That means we can have table views, buttons, labels, switches, and others. Okay, this was a general overview of the MVC design pattern, and for more please visit us at techytube.com. Thank you.